Hey guys, this is William with another video for PlayAgricola.com's YouTube channel and twitch.tv/play_Agricola. I'm playing a Montu Mixtape Collection game with Field Watchman, Mercator, and Montu. And I'm not sure if Montu's streaming, but he usually streams at twitch.tv/gamermontu, so you can check him out there. He's been streaming quite a bit, actually. He usually streams in the evenings after I'm done, so he's been streaming quite a bit, so you can check him out. And he is streaming, so you can see his perspective of this game. All right, looking at this first pile, 24601's good. I'm not usually happy to first pick it, though. Tarot Lover, if you're three... Oh, wow. Tarot Lover. Okay, so this is Pasture Lover, but for Field Watchmen. So, three planted fields, four fewer building resources of your choice for each new... Yeah, so I'm pretty sure I know what I'm taking. Each time you use Major, you get a grain, and afterwards you can take a sow action. This seems very good with Tarot Lover. Like, build the fireplace, get a grain, and sow it right away? That seems good to me. Walrus Hunter, we know. Alright, yeah. I'm taking Tarot Lover here. I would love to wheel Young Farmer. If I don't wheel Young Farmer, maybe Resource Seller, maybe Manual Labor. Manual Labor is going to be pretty good in a game like this where I'm going to want to do one action resource grab, one action plow, or take crops or whatever. But yeah, this looks like a pretty clear Tarot Lover, and hope I get past something like Field Doctor or Country Doctor or anything like that. Okay, you try to make Agrarian work here. Yeah, this is... is this Visionary? Getting the vegetable with Visionary is good. Probably with Tarot Lover, my build room action will come after everyone else's anyways. The only thing is, should I be taking Omni Farmer here? I guess that's the question, is should I be taking Omni Farmer instead? Omni Farmer is fantastic with early crops. It's a good card. Yeah, it's kind of a question of Visionary or Omni Farmer here. And honestly, wheeling Agrarian, this might be a game to try to make Agrarian work. The problem with Visionary is that I don't use the boar. Well, I don't use the boar well at all. I really don't use the boar well. So it's nice that it gets a vegetable, but yeah, I think I'm taking Omni Farmer here. The other problem with passing Visionary is that the player who has Visionary will go after the Agrarian. So that is a problem with picking a Visionary here. I think... Not Field Doctor, yeah, like Country Doctor. Or Field Doctor if I could get rid of the fourth field. Yeah. I think I'm going Omni Farmer here. The other thing is I don't have to go all in on Tarot Lover. Like, I don't have to force three fields. I can plow one field and sow one field. And there are some really good cards that enable that. Oh man. Vineyard Labor is pretty great here. We've also got Cabbage Lover. I honestly think Mechanical Breeder is going to be pretty good. It's going to prove to be quite good. And with Omni Farmer, Mechanical Breeder could be quite nice. But this is pretty clearly Vineyard Labor. Vineyard Labor lets me skip out on having to worry about taking grain or food. It lets me plow two fields, sow a grain and a wood and a food, and then save all the reed on my wood rooms and one wood, which is looking quite good. So, yep. Yeah, Mechanical Breeder coming back would be nice, but I'm probably going to be left with Cloister Brewer or Livestock Expert. I don't really want those two. Guessing one of those two is what I'm left with. Yeah, so Childcare Worker is not too bad because I should be able to get lots of wood with Vineyard Labor. It gives me a reason to sow multiple wood, and then I can turn wood into food with Childcare Worker. The other thing here is Pepper Farmer. So Pepper Farmer, with Pepper Farmer, it's good incentive for me to go back to the sow space. Vineyard Labor's already telling me to go back to the sow space. I think I'm gonna take Pepper Farmer over Childcare Worker. Can I put wood on Omni Farmer? Place one harvested crop. So wood is unfortunately not a crop. Unfortunately. Oh, 24601 is still here. Oh, meme is blocking card six. Oh, sorry about that. Sorry about that, guys. I like, okay, 24601 is good. I actually like manual labor quite a bit here. So manual labor procs off of me harvesting. Does it proc off me harvesting wood? It might not proc off me harvesting wood. It definitely procs off me getting wood when I sow for vineyard labor. I think with manual labor, this should just be one wood per round for a bunch of rounds, and that's going to be pretty good. Yeah, I really can focus on wood, and then when I'm ready to reno, it can get me clay, and when I'm going to reno to stone, it can get me stone, and I'll probably try to do like one read action the whole game where I get two or three read, and manual labor makes them four, three or four. So if I get a miner with a read on it, that would be pretty good. Yeah, this is looking, I like this start. This should be a very interesting game. Get crops sown early, get not crops, get stuff sown early. Yep. Everyone's in the game, everyone's seated. Yep. Oh, Visionary's still here. I think I'm gonna try to make Agrarian work. The fact that Visionary is still here might mean that Agrarian actually can work. Visionary plus Omni is not bad. No, you're right. Visionary Omni Farmer is not bad at all. But I can't really use the boar unless I fence or draft a minor way to hold the boar. Visionary plus Pepper Farmer also. Do you think I'm likely to play that many occupations in stage one? Like I would need so much food to play that many occupations. Which like it works maybe if I build the first fireplace. Visionary is a good card. And I guess you know what? Visionary plus manual labor gets me an extra stone. So I can think about that as well. The round that I visionary in, if it comes with a plow action or maybe a fence action, it gets me an extra stone. I'm kind of afraid of doing too much. I feel like it's gonna be. So the nice thing about Agrarian is that it gets me fields without using actions. Well, I do have to use actions, but those actions are me taking food, which is not as bad. Visionary is a lot stronger than Agrarian. You know what? I'm remembering the major minor grain sow card. Honestly, people shit on Agrarian, but it's not. It's every time I've seen it played, it's performed better than expected. Every single time I've seen it played. But you know what? I'm remembering the major minor sow grain card, and that player will definitely go after the Agrarian. So I think I'm gonna go Visionary here. And I'm really hoping to pick up a minor improvement. Ranch collector here. The auto farming of Cloister Brewer is nice. Cloister Brewer is super auto farm if I get like grain cart or corn scoop or something. Ranch Collector could be fine though as well. Yeah, auto farming with Cloister Brewer looks pretty good. Okay. I think this is ground pickaxe plow. That's how I'm getting my three fields with ground pickaxe plow early. It's more expensive than threshing machine plow. Threshing machine plow would be better because it saves me two wood, but getting a way to get the three fields with one action look really nice. Yeah. If I could wheel Festival Hall, that would be fantastic. Because Festival Hall can turn the grain into stone. Oh, Potter's Plow. Oh. Oh, that feels bad. But Bountiful Harvest. Harvest two resources, breed an animal. Yeah, Bountiful Harvest is great here. Bounty. I have two occupations that trigger bounty, Pepper Farmer and Omni Farmer. So that between that and Visionary, I'd be looking to build a cooking hearth so that I can eat those vegetables. I should read Farm Sparrows, I guess. And if you use take grain, sow, bake, or plow, add a food to this card. Oh, this one's fun. Take grain, sow, bake, plow field. When there's three, you can put them on different spaces and get a point. That's a fun card. Potter's Plow is really good. I kind of wish I hadn't taken Ground Pickaxe Plow. Potter's Plow would be good. I guess I should read Proofing Jar. If you don't take BR, you can bake a grain. I think I have to take Bountiful Harvest here. Bountiful Harvest could be 5 points. Six, probably not 6 points, but it could be 5 points. Yeah. I'd love for Bounty to wheel. Wood grab miner plow. But what I mean, yeah, sorry. But what I mean is, once I'm ready to plow, the ability to do all of them with one action is really nice. But yeah, you're right. About two actions. The planning is easier, yes. I would consider making a draft proofing jar. I should wheel it. Yeah, I think proofing jar won't be very good this game because of vineyard labor, manual labor. Make all those. Well, exactly. Sorry, that's what I mean. Yeah. You're articulating it better than I did, Mariska. Wow, cash crop. And prize squash. Oh man. I mean, sowing food or wood onto cash crop is going to be really phenomenal. Yeah, I probably only have four or five fields, so prize squash is good, but not like crazy broken. Whereas cash crop, yeah, because pepper farmer gives me a place to sow. Cash crop gives me a place to sow, so like three, four, like four or maybe five fields is more than enough. Yeah, I'd love prize squash, and I'd love for bounty to wheel. Although, to be fair, cash crop might want to come, and bountiful harvest might want to come out before I have time to play bounty. I'm just gonna have a lot that I'll want to do. A lot. So as it stands now, I don't have to play Ground Pickaxe Plow. Because pepper farmer and cash crop both count as planted fields. So I could plow one field, play pepper farmer, play cash crop, play vineyard labor, play visionary, sow a vegetable onto pepper farmer, wood onto the field, and food onto cash crop, or vice versa. Actually, food is not a good, so the wood, it has to be wood onto cash crop if I want the points for it. Yeah, because cash crop can't convert food into wood because it's not a good. Or food into a point because it's not a good. Right. There's some stuff going on here. There is some stuff going on. So the thing I'm still not totally sure about is how I'm feeding. I'm pretty sure it's a cooking hearth. However, I still don't have a way to hold these boar yet. I could just force a way to hold the boar, like build fence 6 or fence 4. I can do that. Oh man, imported timber. Breeding straw, one boar to breed during the harvest, cart can hold a boar. Take a grain and start player instead of four wood and fence. Fertile soil is really good. The problem with imported timber is I'm playing it in round three and then needing to play visionary after, which means I can't play any ox before that, and that's a problem. That's a problem. Fertile soil is really good, so I'm probably taking fertile soil here. Yeah, breeding straw is interesting. It's very interesting. If I had any way of getting grain, I think I'd do it. But I think just forcing the fences is almost as good. Festival Hall is still here, and Alms Wield as well. Well, that means someone should not be taking occupations, right? Yes, this is going to be a very good Omni Farmer hand. Yes. What I really would, you know what I really needed? Instead of fertile soil or festival hall, I needed flat hill. Flat hill would have been perfect. And that way I know I can do a 5-room clay house minimum. And then I could try to go for stone with all these crazy points. Potter's plow is still here? That's crazy. I feel really bad about first picking ground pickaxe plow. I really don't need Potter's plow. Like, ground pickaxe plow is more expensive and the wood becomes available for my opponents, but these two cards have the same effect. I don't need both of them. I'm not gonna plow six fields. Unless I get, if I get Veg Pumpkin Patch, maybe, or Prize Squash, maybe, but. Gold medal. I have too many miners. I have lots of cheap, easy miners. I think I'm probably not playing gold medal. A kitchen table might be fine here. Edible roots, probably, is the pick. Steamer stinks. Huh. Well, the miners, I did not get the miners that I was hoping for with this, with my occupations, but you still be able, it should be able to make something happen here. Corral also would have been good. Man, I just always want Corral now. Since we've been playing with G Deck again, I'm just always like, man, Corral would be great here. Just take the second plow anyways. Honestly, I think I don't Chet because I'm gonna plow one field without using ground pickaxe plow. So that means I have four fields already spoken for. So that means Potter's plow is the sixth and seventh field, which is not doesn't do anything for me. Because my plan is plow one field, play pepper farmer, play cash crop. Those are my three fields for Tarot Lover. I'm in third, okay. So three wood would be fine. Three wood or expensive auk. I'm happy with either. Expensive auk manual labor into two wood. I really don't want Reedstone food. That's the one thing I don't want. Family physician here. I'm gonna expensive auk manual labor, I think. It just seems like it's gonna be a great manual labor game. Three wood is good, but if I manual labor like twice, it's almost as good as three wood, and it does more long term. Like the fact that manual labor can proc off vineyard labor and proc off visionary is gonna be good for me. Also, I should acknowledge I'm seated next to Montu. So if Montu nurs, going late, like visionary growing late is fine. It's not that much of a downside because I might be in that position anyways. My head. No, you're not wrong. And Potter's Plow is better than Ground Pickaxe Plow. You're right about that. That Potter's Plow is better than Ground Pickaxe Plow. There is an argument in this game that with manual labor, Ground Pickaxe Plow could be marginally better because I could take the wood that I put somewhere and use it to trigger manual labor. But you're right that most of the time, Potter's Plow is going to be better than Ground Pickaxe Plow. Feels bad, but I'm going to start playing cash crop here. Feels bad to not trigger manual labor, but. I've got plans. I've got plans here. Big plans. Then my round two is. I'm probably not pepper farmer and sowing until stage two. I just won't have enough food to get all that done. So my round two is three wood and a cheap and expensive auk probably. Or three wood, two wood, or three wood. Well, I can't three wood fence, but three wood, two wood might be okay. Cheap flipped. I should get expensive auk back, right? These three things all get taken: cheap auk, Reedstone food, two reed. So three wood, expensive auk looks good here. Expensive auk, vineyard labor, and then I'm hoping. Fence flips in three, so that round three can be like fence four and visionary, and then round four is oh, actually no, that doesn't work because I'm never getting cheap occupation second action with in three. So my round three has to be what? What am I fencing? I guess that's the problem. I guess if fence doesn't flip in three, I could build two stables. I could do that. Is manual labor the new meme? Honestly, it's not even a meme. It's just a good card. I think it's just a good card. I think it's wood collector with pretty significant upside. You need the right hand for it, but. Play Ag Labor. Montu plays Bounty. Yep. I think Montu has prize squash, guys. I'm just guessing. I have this funny feeling that Montu might have prize squash. Okay, so I think my round three could be plow into sow. If round three is sow, I could do plow into sow. That triggers manual labor, gets me an extra wood. Let's see what it is. It's fence. Okay, so fence four, and I could still fence four and sow. Fence four and sow is still doable here. Treehouse builder. Oh, so's not here. What am I saying? I said I was going to take so, but I can't take so because it's not available. I should do an action that provides a resource. Should I? Four clay. I do want a cooking hearth. And then maybe my round four is visionary and cooking hearth. And I manual labor a stone. Sounds like a plan. I'm glad I have your blessing. All right, so I need cheap ok to get here. I need cheap ok. There's a reasonable chance at getting it. Major minor works as well. I'm okay with eating a boar. But yeah, I'm hoping ideally for food cheap ok. I mean, Field Watchman is basically forced to three sheep first move, right? Mercator, we might see Mercator first move four clay for, oh, never mind, resource dealer. What am I talking about? No, I was thinking resource seller, not resource dealer. So Mercator will read stone food if it's there. We know Montu loves read stone food. All right, stage one complete. Well, not quite, I guess. I'm pretty sure Mercator's taking reed. Nope, Mercator takes wood. Okay. Stage one complete. I got visionary. Montu builds, didn't have to build, but does build. Maybe worried about a start player miner, clay miner from Mercator. That would be the only way that Montu gets jumped, I think. I guess Field Watchman could start player here, but. Yeah. Yeah, that's the two ways that Montu gets jumped. Field Watchman start player or Mercator clay miner on start player. Too bad. Field Watchman for some reason needs crazy amounts of food. Oh well. I didn't think he would three sheep, four food traveling players. That seemed unlikely to me, but oh well. I'll build the cooking hearth. Maybe guest room. Yeah, it could be guest room. Okay, this round, want to keep up my trend of triggering manual labor, and I'm going to need more wood. So I think this is three wood and then occupation pepper farmer or plow. I want to save my sow action until I can sow vegetable on pepper farmer, wood on cash crop, and food on the field. So, yeah, I want to make sure I'm getting manual labor on wood as many rounds as possible because ultimately I want to be building three rooms for 12 wood. Mercator wheeled three reed here, which is pretty great. I guess I'm not taking reed at all, so. Maybe I should have taken reed there. You know what? Three reed plus a reed is as good as three wood because both of them can be used. Except that I for it to use five reed, I have to build. Yeah, maybe taking reed was correct there. I'm not sure. Play pepper farmer. Plus wood. Yeah, Field Watchman has guest room. Start player guest room will be pretty devastating for Montu here. Montu might play around it actually, and just although Montu kind of wants to build a cooking hearth, I kind of like cooking Hearth here for Montu with Bounty. Especially if he has more, like we know he has prize squash. So especially if he has more like miners that give him net plus one food. Or his bounty's two food, right? Two food for a veg. Oh, yeah, it's one food for a veg. Even better. I don't know why I keep thinking bounty is two food for a veg. Devastating for Monty. Better go look at his stream. Yeah, Field Watchman's four food traveling players is. I'm dis. I'm. I don't know why. I don't know why he decided to play it, but it's really too bad. Because with Treehouse Builder, we can presume that Field Watchman is not going to spam family growth. He's going to try to grow one time. So, you know, doesn't seem like he needs that much food with the first fireplace, but I am, you know. This is plow into sow here. Plow into sow, trigger manual labor for a wood, and I'm hoping to get three sheep in round seven. Which, if Field Watchman first action builds, Montu will have to start player. So then Field Watchman could take the three sheep in front of me in seven. Yeah, Montu's not, he's not even gonna risk it. He's just gonna start player Potter's Plow here. Oh well. I mean, maybe Field Watchman decides he doesn't need six food, hopefully. I think that's what I need to hope for. Also, Potter's Plow, seventh for Montu is incredible. Incredible. I'm so sad I first picked Ground Pickaxe Plow. Oh man. I'm so sad. I saw Potter's Plow sixth! Can't believe it. Burger Flipper for Mercator. So Mercator's definitely. Wait. All the hearths are gone. That's sad for Mercator. Alright. Sowing. Three wood on cash crop. Three food here. And vegetable on pepper farmer. I get an F and a wood. Did I do this right? I feel like I might have screwed something up. I should end the rat turn with as much wood and food as I started with. I think I might have given myself an extra wood. Four wood, one food. I did give myself too much. So the things that I get. And then get an extra wood at the end of the round. I get a food pepper. Oh, I did it right. Food pepper wood. Yes, okay, I did do it right. Oh no, J pepper, not food pepper. Sorry. I get the food when I harvest. There we go. That's right. Yeah, if I can three sheep, bountiful harvest. So does manual labor trigger off of harvesting crops? I don't remember if that's been decided. I mean, that to be fair, that's like 5 years old. It's not the most up to date. Yeah, it's just like too much. The problem is there's not enough consensus. There are too many other rules that I don't know the answers to, that it's like if there was a really clear consensus on a bunch of stuff, I feel like I could put it in, but oh, I get the three sheep here. That's great. Three sheep here is great. So three sheep into manual laboring a wood. What do you guys think? Oh, you know what? I don't harvest, you must exchange them. Oh, so I do still harvest it. Maybe I'll look at manual labor in here. Politician plus manual labor. It's not exactly the same. I think probably no. Think the answer is probably no. Very happy to get three sheep here. That's fantastic. Fantastic. Yeah, I don't know if it counts as harvesting. I guess I should just look manu yeah. Look in France deck. Manual labor. Yeah, it's not in here. I'm guessing no. I'm guessing it does not work. I think I'm supposed to play Tarot Lover here so that I can build first action next round. I'll ask anyways. I think the answer is no, but so then I eat a food here, a food from Pepper, and a sheep. Monty says yes. It says in any way. According to rules of harvest, yes it works. Oh, awesome. What are you referring to, Rylo Kren? Is there something where you looked at and saw something that seemed like an answer? It makes a difference because it changes how much wood I have here. It changes whether I can double build or not. Comes off field, goes into your personal supply as all goods in the harvest. Oh, you're looking at cash crop. Yes. But the question is not do I receive the wood? It's does moving the wood off of cash crop count as receiving? That's the question. And I'm not sure that that's the case. I'm not sure that that's the case. Yeah. I'll do this either way. I think this move is the same either way. Three wood into double build. You're right. I did search the wrong thing, maybe. Is food a resource? Food's not a resource, right? You receive grain outside the harvest, you get a food. Implies that you still receive a good at the harvest from your fields, otherwise there would be no distinction. Resources are BR in crops, yeah, but food is not a resource. Yeah, I think I disagree, Rylocran, because there are other ways that provide crops. But I'm not 100% on this. I'm building two wood rooms here. You receive a veg from the harvest, doesn't trigger Market Woman, but she specifically states how her power triggers. Yeah. Would I be penalized from Fiddler if I harvested wood from cops? That's a good question. Yeah, that's a good question. I could look at the cops compendium. I should have two wood left. I think only one. Because I spent four wood on each room. I think I go from eight to zero and then get one. But yeah, the cops compendium is a good place to look. Does not count for the storehouse clerk. If it doesn't count for the storehouse clerk, then I think I'm receiving it. Okay, yeah, the cops entry convinces me. Three on each room. Did I do that wrong? Four few. Oh, it's four fewer BR. I spent too wood too much anyways. You're right. Rylo Kren, where's the cash crop? Is that in the WM compendium? Where are you seeing that? Yeah, I think I have one extra wood. I must be looking at an old. Do I have an old WM Pi compendium bookmarked? What's the most recent version? 0.5 is the most recent one that I have. Where were you seeing it? Where'd you copy it from? Comes off your field, goes into your supply. Okay, so yeah, you weren't directly quoting a compendium. Yes. Okay, that makes more sense. All right, I'm on board now. I'm gonna start player here. I can. How do I feed? I feed if I eat two sheep. All right, I'm gonna start player here so that I double grow. Double grow looks like a good idea. You got that link from an interesting. You're right. Okay. And what's this discussion? Cash crop definition. Oh, okay. So you just searched up cash crop. All right, so I need to feed five here. I get a food from Pepper Farm. I can eat two food from a sheep. I get a food from this field. I harvest this, get a wood. And then, so what did I say? I'm at four food, so I need one more. So I can eat a second sheep, or I could eat a vegetable, or I could eat the bountiful harvest food, which maybe that makes sense. Eat this one just so that I can keep the sheep breeding. Oh, this happens after because it happens during the breeding phase. All right, so I have to eat. Oh, but then if I eat my sheep, I'm not breeding, so I have to eat a vegetable here. All right, so plus F pepper, harvest F, eat H, and V. All right, there we go. Edible field is more food. I don't actually think I can play edible field because I don't actually have. I have three grain field. I have three planted fields, but I don't really have three fields, if that makes sense. I'm pretty sure I think for some reason playing edible roots here seems wrong. And I'm not really, I can't really explain why. But playing edible roots here seems like it should not be allowed. But you're right, if I could play edible roots, I would have an extra food and not have to eat the vegetable. You're right about that. Regarding messy rulings, yesterday we didn't know how Gollum. Okay, I can't. Gollum, I can't deal with. I don't. Gollum's like Sunday worker and giant in that. Yeah, that's a really messy one. That's a really messy one. I would say, it would depend on the wording on food wood cart. I'd have to look at it. Yeah, Gollum, Sunday worker, giant, they all of them cause problems. All of them cause problems. Family growth is uncontested, I believe. So I can take two boar here or six wood. Six wood looks really good. Yeah, Gollum is really messy. I don't know how to speak to that one. I wonder if this is the round I'm supposed to take clay in for my reno. If I'm supposed to take two boar, clay, and family growth and trigger manual labor from taking clay. Wonder if that was correct instead. Boar is gone, field's gone. I was thinking about maybe taking family growth to third action plow, but plow is, that's obviously not an option. Could take grain here. Is sow contested next round? So I can ask myself that question. Is sow contested next round? Because I definitely want to sow on my pepper farmer again. Maybe I'll just play it safe and sow here. Also, if I sow next round, it messes up
taking resources from someone up somewhere else. It messes up manual labor, like if I want to take clay next round, or reed or stone. I can also sow off of a plow. I can. I'm kind of holding that for the end of the game, though. Not the end, but later on in the game. I'm trying to hold on to it. Because ground pickaxe plow, like, I'm more interested. Like, if I put a wood on grain, I'd be pretty happy to take grain myself, for example. I could have played Omni Farmer. That's the other thing I could have done. We'll see. Last move, family growth, GPP. Plus wood. Yeah, not getting a sow action would be really bad because of Bountiful Harvest and missing out on a point from Pepper Farmer. I wouldn't multiply bonuses. 3 wood on the space, double it. Oh, 3 wood on the one accumulating space. Okay, so I can answer this maybe a bit better. That you're doubling the resources taken. So you double, Gollum doubles, I believe Gollum doubles the 3 wood. So you get 3 wood twice, but then I would argue you only get wood cart once. But maybe you get wood cart twice if it depends on taking wood. Because the idea is you're using the space twice, but using the space twice on an accumulation space, of course, doesn't do anything because there's no resources the second time. So we say to get around that, take double the resources that are there. Now, technically, if you are taking the space twice, you should get wood cart twice because wood cart activates whenever you take wood from a space. However, in this case, maybe the wood taken is not from the space, it's from Gollum. In which case, woodcart should trigger once. So I would say you should end with, if you take 3 wood with Gollum, with woodcart, you should probably end up with 8 wood. That would be my, I think that's where I'd come down. Okay. Yeah, the clay is not good here, so I don't really want the clay. Sheep? How hungry are these guys? Not super hungry. Hard to say. Don't really want to have to first move fish. I'm going to manual labor a wood this round. So I think I play Omni Farmer here. That's what I do, first move. With Sunday Worker, double woodcart as well. I don't remember the text on woodcart exactly. Gollum specify. Oh, Gollum specifies that you put. Oh, okay. All right. So Gollum is different. So we're thinking. I don't play with Gollum very often, Yellinger. I think about. I play with Giant and Sunday Worker a lot more. So Sunday Worker and Giant both say double the amount taken, but you're right that Gollum, if Gollum says you get the amount you put on each round, that makes me what I said wrong. So sorry about that. I'm not that familiar with Gollum. The card's intent is to take the action twice. Yes, agreed, Sid. Agreed. Should I fence 11 here? Fence 11 looks okay. I have 12 wood, I get one more wood from manual labor, from cash crop. So then I have enough for ground pickaxe plow, plus any more manual labor wood is for festival hall. Yeah, fence 11 looks okay. The question is, do I have to do it with this move? Could I start player here, for example? Start player kitchen table. You know what? Taking food is probably good. I get food from Pepper Farmer. I want to Omni Farmer a sheep. I want to put a sheep onto Omni Farmer. So I definitely want to take grain. I need to feed 8 here. So sheep. Do I want to eat a veg again? If I can avoid eating a vegetable again, that seems reasonable. Alright, I'm going to take 1 cattle here. And just eat it right away. It is clunky, yeah. Could build a 4th room. Or a 5th room. 5th room and grow. Play edible roots. I'm not even sure I can play edible roots yet. I'm not sure if I legally can. It feels wrong. Edible roots off of, like, these. It feels wrong. It feels like they're planted fields, but not actually fields. Which is weird. I probably can, but it feels wrong. I don't know. Want to start player wild fruit. Okay. Yeah, so I'm going to grain and fence, I believe, as my final two moves. Mercator's got cat lover. Latest cat lover ever. Montu's got prize squash plus cabbage lover. Montu's gonna have a lot of points. He's gonna so get up to 8 vegetables. And those vegetables are gonna be worth a lot of points. And he's gonna buy another vegetable when he plays prize squash. Yeah, Montu's got some nice stuff going on here. Really nice stuff.
Sheep to Omni. That goes there. That goes there. That goes there. All that's removed. And I still have three sheep. And the sheep goes onto the Omni Farmer, which I will mark when it's my turn again. So, how contested is Plow One Field? Field Watchman doesn't want to do it anymore. Montu might start player again. Montu has Prize Squash. Montu will start player if it's still there. So, I'm pretty sure Montu will not Plow One Field. Montu will Prize Squash. So, I think I can take the two boar here. Although, I guess I can ask myself, does anyone else actually want these boar? It's six food for Field Watchman. But he's got all these crops already. Ooh, I probably need a manual labor clay here, right? If I'm going to try to reno. Maybe I'm not going to get to reno. I think I take the two boar either way. I need to mark my Omni Farmer, I forgot. I'll try to get to clay. I'm not getting to stone, but I should be able to get to clay. Stone oven's still available, so some amount of clay plus redstone food is a thing. I also have festival hall. If I think field's going to keep going around, I can grain into field. Grain into field, so yeah, I could do that. I mean, joinery is still available. What am I saying? I should be playing joinery. And continue taking wood. Continue getting Omni Farmer manual labor from wood. Yeah. Oh, Montu plows. Wow. Definitely expected start player. Alright, I'll start player. Kitchen table. And I'll take Plow So. Although putting the wood on family growth is great for Montu. He'll say thank you when I do that. I don't think there's much I can do about that, though. Also, both Field Watchman and Mercator want family growth at the end of the game here. I wonder if Mercator forgot about Field Watchman's Treehouse Builder. Kind of odd. You know what? I really don't care about start player here. I want to start player Festival Hall, but I don't want to start player before then. I could get screwed if Mercator takes Plow One Field first move next round. That would be bad for me. But otherwise, I think this is okay. Two clay, manual labor, plus a clay. So that's four clay for my reno. And then I can try to get reed. Oh, maybe that clay move was... I don't know. I keep going back and forth between whether or not that was good or good or not. I'm still not sure, to be honest. I mean, I can clay oven,
I don't know. I'm not sure. I'm not really sure what I should be doing. Maybe Mercator will start player. That would be neat. Though he might reno here. He definitely forgot Treehouse Builder. Yeah, I figured as much. Yeah, Clay Oven. I don't know. Yeah, Clay Oven. Mercator likes the Clay Oven. Otherwise, he doesn't really have a way to use these resource dealer resources. Yeah. I don't know, Monty's complaining about his game. He had kind of this like crazy amount of improvement points. And he has a lot of bonus points. Alright, I guess I'll start player. No, not Festival Hall. Kitchen table. And I labor a clay. Plus wood F, wood onto cash crop. Yeah, that works. Yeah. I should have one more field. Thank you. Thank you, Agrippina. Agrippina. Could sow a food. Yeah, but I'm not going to. Because I'm hoping to get plow one field in 14 to trigger my fertile soil. And that way I can sow a grain of probably a grain and two vegetables or two grain and a vegetable. Because I want to trigger pepper farmer again. It has been a good day for subs. Yes, it has been. Really good day. Like 4 so far, I think. Fofo, Yellinger, Enwall, and Joe. Yeah. Ooh, Monty taking the two cattle. Is he really that hungry and eating both of them? That's surprising to me. I'm quite surprised by that. get a start player. That Plowso action is worth a lot in the last round. Then I'll take Reed and Reno. Unless Field Watchman takes Reed here, then I have to think about what I'm doing. I think Sitzel has been. I haven't seen him on the site at all. I think he just hasn't been playing Agricola at all. Civ in chess sometimes. Oh, yeah. Redstone food here. There's the prize squash. Yeah. Redstone food is fine, though. I took Redstone food. Don't understand why I didn't start player that. Yeah. Yeah. For Plowso in the last round and so like six vegetables. Yeah. That's yeah. I guess he took the cattle and then his second move was three wood. So I'm not sure if the wood was important. I'm gonna take two wood here. It lets me build the joinery on Reno. Is that okay? Yeah, I think that's fine. I eat a sheep. I omni a boar. Eat a sheep, omni a boar, and a vegetable. Yeah, I think that's fine. Oh. Oh, that actually does matter a little bit. So he should have one sown one fewer vegetable there.
Okay. All right, so I have to do my stuff. So I harvest a vegetable. I get a food from Pepper Farmer. I get a food from Edible Roots. Wood goes to Cash Crop. I get this. I harvest these. So I can eat a sheep. Then three food, HV, feed eight. And I'll put a boar on Omni. Yeah. Looks good. Oh, and edible roots. I get edible plus F2. All right. I think everything's good. Food on Bountiful Harvest. I think I've done everything right. Yes. So on to Pepper Farmer for my third point. So grain will go on to Omni Farmer, obviously. Yep, looks good. Oh, I get plus what F. Yeah, my hand is quite synergistic. So even though I had to eat the two boar in round four, this game was pretty great. So Montu is at 4 family members, Field Watchman's at 5, Mercator can family growth with room, so it's just Montu and I who want family growth without room. The cattle is wanted by Field Watchman and Montu, but there's also 2 boar, so one of them might take the boar first. It's all family growth here. Oh, I need a Reno. I forgot about Reno. Reno build the joinery. It's okay. Mercator still needs to take stone. Mercator will Reno fence. Okay, I'm not worried about that. Yes. Why would they take boar over cattle? Because there's 2 boar on the space, so they breed to become a third point. So it's a 3-point move versus a... If you have no cattle or boar, the 2 boar is 1 more point than the 1 cattle. Because it goes from -1 to 2 versus -1 to 1 in the scoring categories. Yeah, no problem. No worries. I'm happy to answer, like, rules questions and stuff like that. I don't mind doing that at all. Don't want people to feel like they can't ask questions like that. Reno's still uncontested. Yeah, Reno's uncontested, so I can take the cattle here. No guest room at all. Yeah, no guest room for Field Watchman. Yeah, Field Watchman just really went crazy on food, which is too bad. Because imagine my game if I don't have to eat the boar. You can imagine my game if I don't have to eat those boar in round four. I think, I wonder if what Mercator drafted. I'm just looking that I was getting useful cards with, like, my 6th and 5th pick, so I wonder if Mercator maybe drafted a bit. I wonder if Mercator could have done a very similar line to what I did. But really, I didn't really get locked in until I took manual labor. Honestly, I love manual labor. Manual labor with Tarot Lover was just very good for me. Field Watchman, friendly worker. Okay, so he's gonna guarantee himself Reno here. But yeah, it doesn't change my actions at all. Yeah, also the fact that I got to grow twice in a row, like the fact that I got to grow in queue was really good for me as well. The fact that I got to grow fourth, that was massive. Because sometimes when you grow this late, you get jumped. I do labor a wood here. But it doesn't matter. The wood's not anything. Oh, the wood got paid off of cash crop. That's where it is. Darn auto pay. So, I pepper a food. I edible roots a food. Grain to Omni. Harvest. So, I need a minus one to Omni. 1, 2, 6. 9, so I can eat one more grain. That's 6. Eat a wood. So I think I need to eat 1 point. Yeah, plus F pepper. I'll eat an H as well to feed 9. So then Omni Farmer has 3 goods on it, so it's 5 points. Cash Crop has 1 more point on it. Bountiful Harvest has 1 more point on it. Yes. Alright. So that's my final farm here. Because I ate a sheep, yes. There we go. So 41 plus a bunch of bonus points. So 9, 12, 17. 41 plus 17 bonus points, 58 for me. Quite good. 5-point cash crop, 4-point bountiful harvest, 5-point Omni Farmer, 3-point pepper farmer. Really good. Really good for me. I had quite a nice hand. So 44 for Montu, Field Watchman, 40, 34, 58, GG. I'm done and win my freedom. Thanks, Sid. Okay, so guys, that was win number 2. Managed to go 2-1. I did tie game 2, and that was with... I got very fortunate. So I'm on a... I've been pretty lucky the last several weeks of 2-Tuesday. I've gotten pretty lucky in general. I've had some days where, you know, this win is, like, pretty uncontested, but, like, the last game was very tight and had some... Honestly, I probably was maybe a little bit fortunate if I look at Mercator's draft. Like... Bountiful Harvest, Cash Crop, just getting, like, it was so good. Honestly, this hand is very good. And I could have starved in round 4. I also should talk about that. I could have starved in round 4 if I don't get 4 food traveling players or major minor back. I thought there was a pretty good chance I got 4 food back, but getting major minor was good. Yes, I do. I'm very satisfied with this performance. Yeah, Tarot Lover seems pretty good. Seems pretty good. So this was a quite strong game. I didn't even need Fertile Soil at all. I didn't need to use it once. Yeah. Okay, guys. So rest of the week,
Evening stream tomorrow, and then I'll stream during the day on Thursday, Saturday, and Sunday. Nice 2 in-days recently. Yeah, that's what I was saying, Fofo. I've had some really. I had like a month where I was doing like, it was like more than 5 games every week, but then the last month or two, it's been like 2, 3 games. So I should go through and compile the stats. I should be doing that to see generally how I'm performing. Guys, I posted in the Discord, so if you're not already in the Discord, check out the Discord. And also on the Play Agricola forums. I'm gonna be doing a charity tournament. Gonna be doing a charity event on this sa Saturday the 19th. So look out for me then. Feel cheated when it's only three. Well, I'll have 4 days this week where I stream 2 games, so you guys will get lots of games. Otherwise, thank you so much to everyone who subbed today. I have to shout out everyone who subbed. So Fofo, Yellinger, Super Enwall, and Average Joe 40. Guys, thank you so much. I really appreciate that. Thank you so much for your support, everyone. It really means a lot. I'd love if everyone could tune in on the charity stream. It would be neat to get some like have some really high like higher than normal viewership, and hopefully get some more eyeballs on the site and everything. I think that would be really cool. As soon as it becomes clear, I win 60. Yeah, go for a 3 win. Yeah. I don't know about that one. I've got to really, if I'm consistently winning 50% of my games, I can do 3 win days, but I'm not gonna do that unless I really like. I'd have to win a lot more of the game my games than I currently do. I'd have to be a better player than I am, realistically. Okay, I'm gonna run a quick ad break, and then we're gonna go raid someone in the board gaming category. Maybe Montu will do another game, although I think he's pretty tilted after this one, understandably, because yeah, it was a rough one. Yeah, we'll raid someone. Maybe Gray or someone will fire up the stream as well. It could happen. So yeah. Otherwise, I will see you guys tomorrow evening.